In natural language, there are many ways to introduce pluralities. Perhaps the simplest way is through morphological marking, for example, changing singular ball to plural balls. In other constructions, however, a plurality may be generated through more complex means, through an interaction with another plural or distributive operator. Consider, for example, the sentence, "His hands held one ball each." Here, one ball is morphologically singular, and yet you infer that there are a plurality of balls, one per hand. Many languages of the world also provide a grammatical way to encode plurationality, that is, a plurality of events. This might be one thing happening again and again, or many things happening at the same time, one ball thrown twice, or two balls thrown simultaneously. Typologically, sign languages fit in perfectly to these cross-linguistic patterns of plurality and plurationality. Additionally, by virtue of their visuospatial modality, sign languages offer new expressive possibilities. On nouns, for example, spatial association may be used to communicate semantic association. Sign languages also display iconicity, pictorially representing the distribution of a plurality across space or time. If you're interested in learning how various natural languages, English, Hungarian, American Sign Language, express the notions of plurality discussed here, check the description for examples and more discussion.